Yeah, welcome back to ProVin in collaboration with FOMAT Solution. In other previous lessons, we talked about real numbers and sets which form part of what Algebra 1. But this very lesson, we are going to talk about complex numbers. That is numbers that do not form part of the real number system, but we still need them for our understanding of mathematics. So let's go and find out what complex numbers are. So we have our topic. Complex numbers. Now, how come did we even get what we call complex numbers? This is what happened. One day, a mathematician was solving a simple quadratic equation, which was in the form x squared plus 1 equals 0. So, he went two steps further, that is, making x squared the subject, giving us x squared minus or equal to minus 1. Now, to find x, we know we have to find the square root of negative 1. So it may either be a positive square root of negative 1 or a minus square root of negative 1. But there is no way we can find the square root of a negative number. So this brought the idea of complex numbers. So they got to a meeting and they all agreed that anytime we have the root of a negative number, say root of negative 1, we write it as I. So the symbol I stands for square root of negative 1. And this is how we got to have complex numbers. Now, any complex number we can talk of occurs in the form, say z is a complex number. It is written in the form a plus bi. Now, why a plus bi? There is a meaning to that. We say the part A is called the real part of the complex number Z, and also the B is the imaginary part of Z. This means that every complex number has a real part which exists in our real number system, and a complex part which we can only what imagine, which we call the imaginary part, and is always moving towards the R. So that's how we can denote a complex number Z. Okay, let's talk about examples of complex numbers. Let's take an example. We can have 3 plus 4i is a complex number. 3 is the real part and the 4 is what? The imaginary part. Don't forget, the value for the I is what? Root of negative 1. Another example we can talk of is, let's say, minus 6 plus 10i. Minus 6, or the negative 6 becomes the real part and the 10 becomes the imaginary part. Also, taking in consideration, let's say 2 minus 15i. The 2 is the real part of the complex number and the negative 15 becomes the imaginary part of that complex number. So now we are conversant with complex numbers, at least for starters or beginners. Arising from such equations, we can find the square root of a negative number. So anytime we have a negative number under a square root, let's say negative 1 under a square root, represent it as what? I. And n. Assuming z is a complex number, we write it in the form a plus bi, where a is the what? Real part of the complex number z, and b is also the imaginary part of what? Z. And we choose some examples. 3 plus 4i. 3 is the real part, 4 is the imaginary part. Negative 6 plus 10i. Negative 6 is the real part, the 10 is the imaginary part. 2 minus 15i. The 2 is the real part, the negative 15 becomes what? Our imaginary part. So this is all about introduction to complex numbers.